Okay, I think it's working. I think it's working pretty well. We can probably raise that for the moment. So, first things first, I am going to just right off the bat say, I do have my fan going, so if you hear some odd noises in the background, that's primarily why. So, yeah, I have a fan going, and the reason I have my fan going is because the airflow in my house is, like, absolutely horrible. It sucks. And, the state of Washington, there was this huge heat wave, and I'm still trying to pull myself back together from it. I was going to stream yesterday, but I went walking around for some exercise, but I wound up overheating myself, despite how thin my layers were, and yeah, I basically just wore myself out, so yeah. I basically exhausted myself, pretty much. But I'm here now. I didn't stream last week. And I didn't stream for most of this week because weather conditions. And, yeah, it was pretty hot. Pretty hot. And, I figured, you know what? If I'm going to stream, it might as well be something that I enjoy doing. So, I've got my sewing stuff sitting around here. Got some pieces that I've already pre-cut, and pieces that I still need to cut. Stuff I basically should probably take care of. But anyway, that's what the stream is here for. So, I'm gonna switch over to this scene. I'm gonna tilt that camera down. And, yeah, you may notice I'm wearing shorts, which is kind of unusual for me, but, you know, it's summer, and as I stated, it's getting hot. So, yeah. Summer, what are you gonna do? I had to check my phone real quick. So, I've got the pieces for the index fingers here. No, this is for the fourth finger. How did this get here? I'll just set that right there. So, pieces for the fourth finger, and these are the index finger. I'm sorry, I screwed that up. But I do have the thumbs here. These are for the boots, so I'll set those aside for the second. And, actually, I wonder if I should cut the blue parts of the boots out now, just so that they're out of the way. They're just mere duplicates of the red part, except they don't get the webbing pattern. So, I'm gonna try. Definitely want to pick your placement out. It makes things a lot easier. And because I have two of the red pieces, I can use them both to figure out the proper placements. Now that I think about it, it probably doesn't matter which way the piece is actually facing, because, so that's not gonna work. Okay. So, I think I more or less have this figured out now. And I should probably draw on the web pattern on the red parts. It would probably be the easiest right now since it's flat. I have my lamp over there, but I but if I angle the lights down there, that should help in letting me see what I'm doing a bit better. Oh, and it makes the blue look a lot brighter, so, yeah, I can definitely work with this. So, I'm gonna trace around this one first. What the heck? Do I have to vacuum my floor again? The crap that I track in when I go off of my walks, so that could probably be the culprit. Maybe I should use a straight edge. I'll hold everything down. This material is pretty stretchable. Okay, got it pretty much drawn out. Now to cut it out. Okay. here. Sorry, I want to make sure I get everything in frame. Ooh. Okay, so the stain's just on the inside. So I'm not sure how well that spot's gonna show up on. Yeah, you can kind of see it. So there's a bit of a stain, like, right there. But you can't really see it on the other side, so it's probably gonna be a good thing that, it's going to attach like this, so then when it's flipped around, you won't even be able to see it, so. I think I know what I'm doing. I might not, but we shall see at the end of the long run. Right. foot part. I don't know. Toe area. Stopped right there. Could be a bit of excess up there, but I don't think I should have to worry about that too much. I mean, after all, I pretty much traced the shape, and that's really all I'm worried about right now. Actually see what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm not sure how well the lines are actually gonna show up. I mean, after all, my laptop cam and the webcam I'm using, like, right there where my scissors are pointing, like, they're not the best quality. Logitech webcam, it was like 20, 30 bucks at Walmart, so. It's not that bad of an investment, but. Still not the best quality. Okay. I'm gonna try to get this as straight as I possibly can. Actual cutoff part at the upper shin area. The red part back on top of it, because yep, this is, I figured.
try it.
Wanna, yeah. Edges. This is one of the hassles of working with this shiny spandex. That's why I prefer working with the matte spandex. Much like satin, the shiny spandex tends to slide around. That, but it rolls up. Why does it do that? I don't know. Okay, it lines up a bit better now. So, now comes the hassle of drawing the web lines on. So I think, I knew there was a reason I had this costume right here. It's the typical Peter Parker Spider-Man suit. So, here's one of the boots. I think I know what it is I gotta do. So I'm gonna start with this one. So I'm gonna start by folding it in half and then pinching it at the crease. And what this does is it gives a fold line. And then, once I have the fold line, make the mark right there. Now I'm going to guesstimate where the other two are going to be. Overlap just a little bit because seam allowance. Thank you. draw the line that's closest to the ankle, I'm going to draw that all the way down. Don't worry, I'll bring it closer to the camera in a second. See that? Okay. Far so good. I knew that was the reason I hit these ultra fine points. Or hated. Excuse me. Try to fold these at about where they meet. Then pinch right there. Hold it for a few seconds. And there. Ha ha! Line, draw this right down. I think I've nearly got it. And ah! Haha! I got the drag lines pretty much drawn. Awesome. Now, water. Thank you. Now for the other side. Oh. This is gonna be kinda tricky. Hopefully I pressed hard enough to where the ink bled through. Okay, ink's not that powerful, but at least I can see where I need to go. Pretty sure other Spider-Man fans are probably gonna get blown away by this handmade, or this man-made, excuse me, because I've actually used quite a bit of a sewing machine on this project. The gloves, though, that is going to be by hand, because there's this whole process of the fingers and the fourchettes and then the thumb being a separate piece. And whenever I've tried to do the fourchettes by machine, it's gotten jammed more than once, so... Thank you. Okay. Now. Ink didn't bleed through enough. Try to get this as accurate as possible. And when I say that, I mean accurate to the other side. This one. Trying to make these like mirror images of each other. Mirror. I have a weird way of pronouncing stuff, don't I? And you probably can't even see what I'm doing. Maybe if I tilt this down. There. You should probably have an easier time seeing what the hell I'm doing. This is getting quite repetitive, but it is necessary. So I want to try to get this. Okay. I see the dots. Just connect them. There we go. Okay, now comes the issue of the actual arches. Because, you know, the boot, like the dragline webbings, those are the straight lines, but then we have those arches that give it some shape. Also grab one of these chisel points and just trying to fill out the top. I didn't ask for the rainfall. At least you showed up, you showed me the thing at all. I have no idea why I started singing Lady Gaga right there, but Rain On Me is actually a pretty good song. outside with how hot it's been getting lately. I wouldn't mind a small rain shower. I wouldn't even mind a hurricane at this point. Jeez. Pretty excited here. Okay. I think I should probably also go over the web lines.